The U.S. government donates an additional 50 million pesos to support relief efforts in typhoon-ravaged areas. The funding will be used to set up 4 emergency logistics hubs in Surigao del Norte, where the UN World Food Program will help transport and distribute relief supplies. The WFP will also assist with re-establishing telecommunications networks to support response efforts. This latest round of funding from the U.S. is on top of the initial 10 million pesos it gave last week. The death toll from Typhoon Odette climbs to at least 389. The Philippines' Disaster Management Agency says 64 people are still missing, while hundreds of thousands have been displaced. A state of calamity was declared in 6 regions last week, but local officials continue to appeal for help as basic commodities remain scarce. President Rodrigo Duterte admits he could have declared a state of calamity earlier if it weren't for a certain law.
The critical is the 3 days. Ang problema, there is a law covering the power to declare a state of calamity insofar as my office is concerned, because it must be based on the assessment and evaluation and the report of the government on the ground. The stupid laws passed by Congress. Sino namang ugok na magawa yan niya immediately so that this could be a declaration? That the law should be changed.
Duterte also told cabinet officials not to evict residents living in no-build zones unless relocation sites have been identified. That's contrary to his earlier statement to consider the summary eviction of families in coastal areas. For now, Duterte ordered the Social Welfare Department to help affected residents put up temporary shelters.
Magbili ka ng trapal, the appropriate size for a family, maybe your target good for 6 people. Kasi ang trapal would protect the people from the cold, the areas where wala pa talagang repair na magawa.
The government is set to release 6 of the 10 billion peso aid promised to victims of Typhoon Odette before the year ends. Acting Budget Chief Tina Kanda says the remaining 4 billion pesos will be sourced from the 2022 national budget, which is expected to be signed into law by President Duterte today.
President Duterte orders the Trade Department to look into reports of profiteering in provinces devastated by Typhoon Odette. He also gave the agency the authority to implement price caps on basic goods and ordered police to arrest those who are overpricing their products.
There seems to be a spike in the prices. They say that some, not all, are hoarding. And you know that it is, you increase the price by selling more than the usual price of, for example, building materials or even foodstuffs, canned goods. Tell us if there has been a violation or violations during this time, because you can identify them, and the Philippine National Police, we will ask them to arrest the hoarders and people who are taking advantage of the situation. We have to put a stop on this, and probably we can go ahead and cap the prices of the goods available, especially medicine.
The DTI, meanwhile, reminds establishments a price freeze is in effect in regions placed under a state of calamity. A total of 50 establishments in Bohol were asked to explain the increase in the prices of their goods, while 2 establishments in Cebu were issued letters of inquiry. Damage to agriculture due to Typhoon Odette now estimated at around 4.3 billion pesos. The Agriculture Department says fisheries took the biggest hit, with losses amounting to at least 1.8 billion pesos. The agency has allotted 2.6 billion pesos in aid for affected farmers and fishermen. Several areas in Oriental Mindoro and Northern Samar submerged in floods due to continuous rains brought by the northeast monsoon and the tail end of a cold front. The bad weather caused two rivers to overflow in Oriental Mindoro. 16 areas are currently underwater. Rescue operations are being conducted, but some areas are currently isolated. Hundreds of people were also displaced. In Northern Samar, water also entered some residents' homes. The rains threatened to destroy agricultural lands in the province.